Welcome back to Mechanical Pros. Got Brian with me. We're gonna be talking about the proper way to do communication cabling for VRV. Brian, we've learned a lot about VRV communication wire, learned a lot of the ways to not do it, a lot of ways to do it. It's kind of tricky. Tell me what we've learned so far.
Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna start off first with the type of wire to use. Very basic, simple wire when we're talking Daikin VRV commercial stuff. A lot of the other stuff out there, maybe 5-6 conductors, special wire. Nothing special about this wire. A 2-conductor twisted pair, copper, no shield, no ground. Very important, no shield, no ground. That'll cause a lot of interference within the comm loop. So Daikin VRV units, they'll use what they call the D3 net is their communication loop. It runs a 16-volt DC signal through this comm wire for the condensing unit or your outdoor unit to communicate with your indoor units. It does this over a daisy chain. So one of the biggest reasons it's so critical to use a twisted pair of wire. If I were to untwist this, I'll have multiple small strands of wire. So if you were to go around the circumference of each wire and compare that all together, add it all together, and compare that to a solid core thermostat wire, way more surface area. Way more surface area on this wire. That's why it has to be a twisted pair. If you don't run the correct wiring, if the unit will even run at all, you'll get communication error codes, all sorts of issues, nuisance. It'll run great for 2 days, then you'll have problems pop up. So very important, 18 to 16 gauge wire, that's the thickness of your wire, has to be copper, twisted pair, 2-conductor, no shield, no ground. Okay, no so shield. Done talking about wire. Now, when I was first coming up, I'd hear control guys talk about running a home run or a star in a daisy chain. I really had no idea what they were talking about. That was controls. I was HVAC tech, but now that I've been doing it much longer, I've learned how that works. So the first thing we'll talk about in comm wiring is a star configuration. Should be this one right here. So here's my condensing unit and my outdoor unit. I'm gonna have multiple wires leave my condenser and go to my indoor units, right? Just like a star. So a big wad of wires back at my condenser going every which way. Then we've got what's called the home run. Just as it stated, we leave the condenser, we go across every unit just like you're running the bases, and then you come back home. So two wires leaving my, one leaving my condenser, one coming back. Daisy chain is what we use in VRV. So one single wire, this wire right here, leaves my condensing unit, hits my first indoor unit, terminates there, and then I'll have another 2-conductor wire, piggybacks over top of these, goes to my next indoor unit, same thing to my next, and it stops on my last indoor unit. It does not come back to the condenser. That is a daisy chain. You'll have wires laying over each other. The great thing about the VRV, they're not polarity sensitive. So if I got a black and red landed here, and then my next set of wires, if I cross that and go red and black, it'll still communicate. It's not polarity sensitive. That'll work all day. Saves a lot of time when you're landing the wires or the control contractor's running the wires. Save them a lot of time as long as they're landing them on the right terminals. It's gonna communicate, it's gonna make it through its startup, save you a ton of time, but I'm telling you, if this little wire, if they use the wrong wire, or they run it in this pattern, it's probably not gonna run to begin with. Be a long couple days popping ceiling tiles, pulling panels, trying to figure out where did that wire get crossed, did they run it the wrong way? A lot of troubleshooting goes in, and startup guy's there to do startup, not there to do troubleshooting, so. Somebody's gonna have to pay him. So always make sure you use the right wire.
Hey, say you have no idea how it was wired or before construction, you're just showing up on the job, people are asking you to check it out. What kind of error codes are you gonna see and how do you start knowing to look at the comm wire?
Great question. So you'll get an error code that'll typically start with a U. If you're talking about Daikin VRV commercials, probably gonna be a U4 error code that's gonna tell me my indoor units and my outdoor unit are not communicating with each other. So the best way I've found to do it, if I'm on a big, especially if it's an existing job and it's a big job, I'm gonna go to my condenser and first I'm gonna make sure I've only got one wire from my condenser going inside the building. Make sure I don't have two or a big wad of wires back there, right? So I very easily pop the control panel and verify that. Then I've gotta go find my first indoor unit in the building. I like to typically try to follow the refrigerant pipe. It's a little easy to pop ceiling tiles and see it. Get to my first indoor unit, I'll untwist this pair. There's gonna be two wires laying over top of each other on this first unit. I'll remove that and then I'll wring it out. I'll twist it together, go to my condenser, check the resistance. If it rings out closed, I know I'm good there. Hook that wire back up, and then I start working my way down to each end. And every time I'm gonna pull the one off going here, twist this one together, wring it out, make sure I got continuity. And that tells me I'm on the same wire, because as a lot of you guys know, you get above a ceiling, it's packed full of stuff, a lot of communication wire up there, telecom, sprinkler pipes, just a mess. They don't give you a lot of room above ceiling. So use your meter, put it on ohm resistance. You just got to start twisting wires together and wringing them out, and that's the way you got to do it. It can be a lengthy process, so super critical it get done right the first time, and you're going to save a lot of time and money for everybody.
Yeah, that's great. That's great advice. You would never think, what type of comm wire you choose could make the difference between a good job and a bad job. Thanks for checking us out on Mechanical Pros. We want to give you guys information to make you have good jobs and be able to serve clients, and come back and check us out for some more tips.